scientists, it's Kanisha again, and I'm feeling a little frustrated with this painting I'm working on today. I'm looking out the window to paint the daytime sky, but it keeps changing. Since I started painting, the sun has moved, the clouds have moved, the sky has even changed colors. It's not easy to paint something that's so different from one moment to the next. What should I do? I don't think we can stop the sky from changing, but maybe we can discover what's in the sky in the daytime and why it changes. Let's observe the sky, keep track of the things we see and how they change. Maybe our observations will give us the answers. I'm going to observe from the open window of the science studio, starting now at sunrise. That's one of the first things you might think of when you picture the sky, right? The sun! Remember, when observing the sky outside, it's important not to stare directly at the sun. It's very bright and not safe for our eyes to look at for too long. I can't quite see the sun yet, but I can tell it's rising. What changes when the sun comes up? What can you see or feel during a sunrise? I notice the light in the sky getting brighter. I also feel the temperature outside getting warmer. Even in winter, the sun brings light and heat to our earth. And the colors, bright shades of red, orange, and yellow, paint the sky as the sun comes up. Let's see what happens after a few hours pass. It's noon, or midday now, and look at how much the sun has moved. The sun moves across and higher up in the sky as the day goes on. In the middle of the day, the sun is at its highest point, straight above us. And the color of the sky has changed too. It's blue now, a lot different than the reds and oranges we saw at sunrise. Wait a second. Look now. The sky is changing again. It's getting a little darker and more gray. The clouds are moving in. They're moving so fast. Do they move on their own? Or do you think something could be pushing them? Oh yes, the wind. We can't see the wind, but we can hear it whistle, feel it on our skin, or see it moving things outside, like our hair or tree leaves. The clouds move across the sky with the wind too. Fewer clouds means a lot of sunlight, and more clouds will block the sunlight. But no matter how many clouds there are, if the sun is up, it's powerful enough to keep giving us light. Let's see what changes as the sun sets. Wow, look at the colors in the sky now. Yellow, then orange, then red. Looks a little familiar, doesn't it? What time of day did we see those colors in the sky before? Right, at sunrise. The sun is low in the sky at sunrise and sunset. When the sun hangs low, red, orange, and yellow light shine through the sky. We can see blue light when the sun is high during midday. As the sun gets lower, its light begins to disappear and the temperature cools down. The sky doesn't get completely dark until the sun goes all the way down. Then nighttime begins. Wow, the sky changes so much throughout the day. But now I understand why the sky makes different light, colors, and even different temperatures as the day goes on. Maybe the best way for me to paint a picture of the sky is to take a picture to capture my favorite moment, or draw a quick sketch when I notice a sky I want to paint. Thanks for helping me today, scientist. Until next time, keep creating. And I'll see you in the science studio. Hey, hey.